Friends, welcome back to my channel Chembasis. So in this lecture, I am going to discuss about acid and base. Okay, so this is the very first lecture on this acid base. So this acid base topic will be divided into several lectures, and this one is the first one. Okay, so first of all, we will learn about what is called the acid and what is called the bases. Okay, so basically there are two theory of acid and base. So the first theory is called the Bronsted and Lowry acid base theory, and the second one is called the Lewis acid base theory. So in this lecture, I am going to talk about this Bronsted Lowry acid base theory. Okay, so according to the Bronsted and Lowry, acid base reaction basically involve transfer of proton. Okay, so what is proton? Proton is nothing but this H plus. So in acid base reaction, it always involves this transfer of proton from one component to another component. There will be transfer of proton according to that Bronsted-Lowry theory. Okay, so what is called the Bronsted-Lowry acid? So those chemicals are called the acid which donates proton. So those components which donate protons are called the Bronsted-Lowry acid. And those chemicals which accept protons are called Bronsted-Lowry base. Okay, so let's understand this Bronsted-Lowry acid and Bronsted-Lowry base using some simple example. So this is a very simple chemical reaction that is taking place. So where basically HCl, that is hydrochloric acid, is basically in contact with water molecules. Okay, so this is water molecule and this is hydrochloric acid. So you can see that this water molecule actually accept proton and become H3O plus. Okay, and this HCl, that is called the hydrochloric acid, it transfer proton to this water molecule. So, and it becomes Cl minus. So in this reaction, you can guess that what is called the Bronsted acid and what is called the Bronsted base, based on the fact that this water molecule basically accept proton. Okay, so it accept proton and become H3O plus. So that's why, as it is accept proton, so according to the Bronsted-Lowry theory, it will be a Bronsted base because it accept proton. Okay, on the other hand, hydrochloric acid, that is HCl, it actually donates proton. So as it donates proton and becomes Cl minus, so according to the Bronsted-Lowry acid base theory, it is nothing but Bronsted acid. Okay, so this is a very simple example showing some acid base reaction, and I have also identified which is called the Bronsted acid and which is called the Bronsted-Lowry base. Okay, now let's go to this one. So you can see in this acid base reaction, this hydrochloric acid HCl loses one proton and becomes Cl minus. Okay, so this molecular ion is called the conjugate base. So it is basically conjugate base of this hydrochloric acid. Okay, so this is a Bronsted acid and its conjugate base is this one, Cl minus, which just lose one proton and become the conjugate base Cl minus. Okay, on the other hand, this water molecule in that same reaction accept one proton and become H3O plus. Okay, so that's why it is called the conjugate acid. Okay, this is basically conjugate acid. H3O plus is basically conjugate acid of water molecule. Okay, so these two terms I have just introduced, that is called the conjugate base and conjugate acid. Okay, now I will discuss about the strength of an acid. So how you can measure the strength of an acid when we are saying that this some acid is very much stronger? So what does it mean? So this means that if any acid A is very strong, it means that it has very high percentage of ionization. High percentage of ionization. It means that if you put this acid in some aqueous solution, most of the acid will be dissociated. Okay, so most of the acid will be in dissociated form. So in that case, this A will be called a very strong acid. So you should not be confused with strength of an acid and concentration of an acid. One acid X can be very highly concentrated, but it may not be the strong acid. Okay. On the other hand, one acid Y may not be very concentrated. It may be very diluted acid, but it has very high percentage of dissociation. So in that case, it is, although it is not a very concentrated acid, but it is very stronger one. So the strength of an acid always depends upon the percentage of ionization. So here, more the percentage of ionization, stronger will be the acid. Okay. Now let's take an example of an acid that is called the sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid. So you can see that in case of sulfuric acid, there are basically two protons. So it has basically two protons to donate according to the Bronsted-Lowry acid base theory. So it has basically two protons. So that's why it is also called a diprotic acid, because it has two protons to be donated. So that's why it is also called a diprotic acid. So if you place this sulfuric acid in aqueous solution, the first proton will be instantaneously donated to the water molecule. So this reaction is very fast. So if you put this sulfuric acid, the first proton will be instantaneously donated to this water molecule and it will become H3O plus. So I have already told you that this is basically Bronsted base, because it accepts proton and it become H3O plus. Okay, and this is basically Bronsted acid because it donates proton and it will become HSO4 minus ion. Okay, and now this HSO4 minus or bisulfate ion further donates one proton to water molecule, but this step, that is the step number two, will be very slow. So that is shown here. So it is most so that's why it is shown by this sign. This sign is very small and this sign is very large, because the rate of this forward reaction where this proton is donated to the water molecule is very, very slow. Okay, so you can see that any diprotic acid, it has basically two proton. The first proton will be always much more instantaneously donated compared to the second proton. Okay, so that thing you have to remember, and why it is so, that I will discuss in some other lecture. Okay, so you can see that in any diprotic acid, the first proton will be always donated much more quicker compared to the second proton. So the transfer of the second proton will always be a sluggish process compared to the transfer of the first proton. Okay, so that I will discuss more in detail when I will talk about the pKa value of acid. Okay, now another thing you have to also remember, that this H3O plus, that is hydronium ion, it is also called the hydronium ion, it is the strongest acid ever exist in aqueous solution or in water. Okay, so nothing beats this H3O plus in water. So no acid is stronger than this. Okay, this hydronium ion, and this hydroxide ion, this one is the strongest base ever exist in water. So whenever I am saying strongest acid or strongest base, here I am also mentioning the medium. Okay, it is always in water. So I am not talking about any other medium. So this is the hydronium ion, it is the strongest acid in water, and hydroxide ion, it is the strongest base ever exist in water. Okay, so these two things also you have to keep in mind. Okay. Now here I am just showing how the sodium hydroxide, if you put sodium hydroxide pellet. You know that this sodium hydroxide basically remain in this type of pellet form. So you may have used this sodium hydroxide pellets in your laboratory, and you have seen that this sodium hydroxide is very easily dissolved in water. Okay, so how this dissolution take place, or how this sodium hydroxide is being remain solvated in aqueous solution, that I have just shown you. So you can see that it has sodium hydroxide has two component. One is sodium plus and another is OH minus. Okay, so you can see that this sodium plus has some positive charge, and the water molecule that is around it has some lone pair of electrons. So there will be some electrostatic interaction between the lone pair of electron and the positive charge of sodium. So the water molecule will be oriented like this around this sodium plus ion. Okay, so this way the sodium plus ion will be solvated in water molecule. Okay, on the other hand, this hydroxide ion, that is OH minus ion, will also be solvated by the water molecule, but in that case the orientation of water molecule will be bit different. So you can see that the interaction will be mainly hydrogen bonding type of interaction, where this oxygen atom and this hydrogen atom of this oxygen water molecule will form a type of hydrogen bond. So these types of interactions are called the hydrogen bonding interaction. So both sodium plus and OH minus ion will be solvated like this. Okay. Now what happens when this aqueous sodium hydroxide reacts with aqueous HCl? So I have told you that in aqueous medium, the sodium hydroxide, the sodium ion will be remain as solvated sodium ion. On the other hand, this OH minus ion will also remain as solvated OH minus ion. On the other hand, if you put HCl in water, that is called the aqueous HCl, instantaneously this hydrochloric acid will donate one proton to water molecule, and it will remain as H3O plus, and the Cl will remain as Cl minus. So that is all here shown here. It will remain as H3O plus and Cl minus. Okay, now you can see that the main reaction will be taken between this H3O plus and OH minus. So this H3O plus will donate one proton to this hydroxide ion, and this hydroxide ion will become one water molecule, and this H3O will also become one water molecule. So overall two water molecules will be produced, and this sodium plus and Cl minus will remain in the solvated forms only. Okay, so this sodium plus and chlorine do not take part in the reaction. The main reaction basically occur in between this hydronium ion or H3O plus and hydroxide ion. So that's why this sodium ion and chloride ion are called spectator ions, because they do not basically take part in the reaction. They do not have any role in acid-base reaction. The effective acid-base reaction that is actually happening here is in between this hydronium ion and this hydroxide ion. So they will react and form two molecules of water. So this is the actual reaction. Okay, so that's it from this lecture. In the next part, I will discuss about the acid-base reaction in terms of the Lewis theory. So in the next lecture, I will basically talk about the Lewis acid-base theory. Okay, so please tell me that how you are finding this lecture. So if you do like this lecture, then subscribe to my channel Chembasis to get instantaneous access to these types of lecture. And if you do like this lecture, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, it's called the Chembasis. And thank you very much for watching this video till the end, and I will see you very soon in my next lecture.